Just one thing to note, okay, that there are many nuances to filing a special leave petition. You all know what special leave petition is. It is there for in this thing, Article 136 of the Constitution of India. You may have seen it, but you may have read it. But this is the actual drafting and filing of SLPs. It's very, very difficult to do that because different statutes are there, different subject matter is there. Sometimes it's criminal, sometimes it's civil, sometimes it's a regulatory statute. In every statute, the requirements are different. Okay, so those things are very important to be careful about. And then there are nuances like, you know, question of law, substantial question of law. These are written actually in the Constitution that, you know, on these grounds or in the Parent Act that on these grounds, an appeal or an SLP is maintainable. So
SLP,
that's the part.
Abhyuday, I'm so sorry to interrupt. SLP is a discretionary power and therefore it becomes all the more. Therefore, there's so many nuances involved in it because you really do not know to what extent the judge will exercise discretion, etc. So in order to know that, you need to understand Supreme Court practice. I think that's the core of Supreme Court practice is to get an SLP moving. So an SLP in civil or criminal matters will be very different. Even in civil matters, from case to case, issue to issue, it will be different. Even in criminal matters, you'll find that if substantial justice has been done, then what happens? Will the court still interfere? So whether the court will interfere or not in an SLP is the biggest question that a lawyer needs to answer. And what tests does he have to meet in order to get the court to interfere and how he can do it, what he needs to be, etc.